The following program contains material that is questionable at best. Viewers are advised to use discretion, since the producers of the program obviously use none. When television signals leave Earth's atmosphere, they travel forever through space. Hence, theoretically, the inhabitants of Zircon may be watching The Family Feud. The airwaves, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the starship Hoover 5, its five-year mission to explore strange new programming, to suck up video from various civilizations, to boldly go into that vast wasteland where all new fall lineups have gone before.
Excuse me, ma'am, what do you say to this? I'll give you these two carrots for that jar of imported olives.
Okay, sure.
How about if I give you this delicious cantaloupe for those bottles of Perrier?
Okay, sure.
Now, how about this 50-gallon drum of super industrial strength hydrochloric acid for your Lide detergent?
No, no way.
$500.
No.
This entire store.
No, I'll never give up my Lide.
Okay, I'm going to make a note of that right here. Won't give up her Lide.
The amazing new Lide. Rorschach ink blot on Johnny's shirt. Lide whisks it away. Thermonuclear waste. Lide penetrates even the toughest grime. And it really is new and improved. Really, no lie. Stardate 2555.5. The starship Hoover 5 is hovering above the planet Nebulous. The ship is part of a network of spacecraft searching for stray intergalactic television signals containing video of any redeeming quality.
CB5 SEO, we have a confirmed stray video signal approaching in the fifth quadrant.
Watch back, Ektar Hoover Boom.
Ready, sir.
Ektar. Wow, nitwit, chopper, junker, vidipoops, and skiplock, millions mock.
Meet Frempton and Herbie. They're not pros by a long shot. But like many backyard battlers, they are avid. Some would say maniacal.
Okay, I'll see that and see you.
Often there's a small wager. Just a game, mind you. But one in which even the slightest edge can spell victory. The smallest oversight, defeat. That's why, in his laboratory, Frempton is secretly creating the amazing magnet ball. It looks just like the regulation model, except for a cleverly concealed console that operates a powerful magnet inside. Later, by remote control, Frempton turns magnet ball off when Herbie shoots. But Frempton activates magnet ball when it's his turn.
And throw it right over the roof. Go right through the net.
No way.
And just watch the difference.
Ready?
Yeah, ready.
I don't even believe it.
Magnet ball is making this game, of course, a rather one-sided affair. And when Frempton forgets to turn magnet ball off, it raises Herbie's suspicions. But of course, Herbie pays off.
Yeah, thanks a lot,
just
sucker.
Like a good sport.
Uh-oh, maggot boom. Earth Nazis and stupid tech fires. Back to you and Viddy Poop, Schlock.
Well, it's easy enough to find out, sir. I can call it up on this terminal.
soup?
Planet Earth, stardate 1983.5, TV viewer, typical.
Happen. Do not panic. The safest response is to befriend the flamingo. Garage sales are wonderful diversions. You can pay almost nothing for something you don't need at all, and it's always fun to speculate, like a real anthropologist, on the lifestyle that would generate such a collection of throwaways. But it's always seemed to me that the homemade signs and modest inventory at most garage sales fail to do justice to this great institution. Maybe that's what caused me to have the dream.
Kansas City Star.
Yes, I'm going to have the world's largest garage sale.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Huge garage sale, hot off the press.
Your attention, please. Huge garage sale at Black's house.
Tonight at 11.
Except for her?
My
man.
Blah.
My
work is.
My work?
Sir, look, it's coming from outer space. We must have left the suction activated.
It is a very intense experience, physically and emotionally.
Stray video showing ducks, sir.
Ducks?
Yes, ducks. Here, I'll show you.
Ducks will eat almost anything, of course, but the first step is to procure the proper cuisine. They prefer French bread. Preferably fresh from the oven.
Excusez-moi, est-ce que vous avez quelque chose pour la duck, s'il vous plaît?
Oui.
Merci.
Having selected the appropriate menu, the next step is to quietly approach la ducks. They may appear unruly at first, but remembering a few simple techniques will help you calm them down. First, simply tear off a piece of bread and throw it into la pan. If this fails to relax the ducks, simply toss a handful of bread into the pan. If pandemonium still prevails, give them some more bread by all means. And if all else fails, try to put the ducks in a more dignified frame of mind. Well, as les Americans say, you can't win them all.
Smelly hoax, muckin' vitty poop slop.
They call them reporters, sir. Here, I'll show you a typical day in a reporter's life.
Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living.
Slow day at the office, afraid the boss might start thinking of you as dispensable. Can't call your clients by long distance because you don't have any. Well, consider the following slow day self-defense techniques.
Technique number one. If your telephone's hooked up correctly, you should be able to use one line to call yourself on the other. And when you answer, loudly enunciate the office's standard salutation.
Reed Black, TV5 Eyewitness News. You're kidding.
Say yeah and uh-huh a lot.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Take notes. Hopefully the boss will overhear.
Where's Reed?
Technique number one is only good for so long, say half an hour.
Okay.
It's only 10:30, far too early to slip out for an extended lunch, and you've used up your trips to the drinking fountain. So, technique number two, visit the restroom, taking plenty of reading material. You don't actually use the facility, of course, you simply hide. Be sure, though, to make the quick change so your footwear won't give you away.
Read.
This technique takes you right up to the lunch hour. Finally, when you return from lunch, slip into clothing that blends with the background. If the wall is blue, wear a blue sweater, so that while you're loafing, the boss can't detect it.
Where's Reed?
Uh-huh.
And by a quarter till five, you're back on the phone to yourself to finish up the day.
Oh, Reed, nice job today.
Hey, thanks, boss. Mm-hmm. Working 9 to 5.
Stop, Scooby-Doo, stop. Stop, stop. Scooby-Doo, Nick Wick, Oz, Pope, Drew.
Sir, something's happening here. Some kind of force is affecting the ship. Look at that console. We're getting stray video we haven't even suctioned up.
Spring forward, fall back. Spring forward, fall back. Spring forward, fall back.
At Daylight Savings Tech, Professor Crono drills his students relentlessly on the basics.
Spring forward, fall back.
Spring forward, fall back. Spring forward, fall back.
All right, students, now we're going to have a little film. In the spring, we spring forward. In the fall, we fall back.
They'll acquire knowledge that few of their contemporaries possess.
Excuse me, ma'am, do you know if we're supposed to set our clocks forward or back tonight?
I have no idea.
Good question.
We're supposed to set them forward.
You're sure?
Yeah.
Okay, now we're
at Tech, the students are tested and retested.
Okay, start.
On the final exam, they must correctly note that when we go to bed tonight, we should all set our clocks back 1 hour. Fall back in the fall.
Time's up. Give me that. You blithering idiot.
It's a rigorous 4-year course, but time flies when you're having fun. And years later, it's fun and easy to spot a fellow Tech graduate.
Excuse me, sir, are we supposed to set our clocks forward or back tonight?
Spring forward, fall back.
Amazing.
Daylight Savings Tech, class of 61.
Of course, tomorrow planetary savings time begins. But that still doesn't explain all the stray video. Look.
Under tight security, we placed 5 pairs of socks in a typical laundry basket.
I'm sorry, but...
That's usual!
Good grief.
Smolder, you hoax.
Sir, it's a magnetic force.
Maggot boob, maggot boob.
Oh, good grief, a bit of a sticky wicket here. Yeah! CB5 SEO, where are we?
We've had no back.
This is a fine mess you've got us into this time, CB5 SEO. Who'd have thought a magnetic ball traveling through space could be so forceful? Those Earthlings aren't as stupid as we thought they were. How am I supposed to watch Family Feud with no video console? Answer me that, CB5 SEO.
I say, CB5 SEO, did you hear the one about the fellow who had a basketball stuck on his head?